Hi everybody, I'm here with the lovely Benny who is in Sydney and we both specialise in design and development across all different businesses and we do contract and perm. And something we've been sort of joking about but talking about is unicorns. What do they look like? How do you become one? And then on the other side, as a business, how do you attract those unicorns slash sort of hard to find talent? And one of the things, you know, that came up in our conversation was adaptability and upskilling. Those are probably the two things I think that talent really should focus on. If you're a designer, then maybe learn a bit of code. Actually, definitely learn a bit of code. And if you're a coder, learn how to design, get to know the marketing team. The more cross-learning you do and cross-training, just add skills to your talent sheet, you know, like your profile and your, you know, CV. You can add those skills in. It really, really does show to your next employer. And talking about clients, I get lots of long briefs with lots of, I want this, I want that, I want that. And the biggest thing I say back is, okay, but why would someone this skilled and this great want to work for your business? What can you offer them? Is there, you know, flexible working? Is there training opportunity? Is there someone that can mentor them? What does the first month look like? What does 6 months look like? You know, I think when you're going out to employ someone that's really niche and hard to find, maybe look at what you can offer them as well to really, you know, attract those mythical creatures. But yeah, me and Ben, we talk about this a lot. So I'll pass it over to you, Benny, to add some more to this conversation.
Definitely. I mean, I wouldn't like to admit how much we talk about unicorns on here, but it's almost daily at this point. I think I absolutely agree with everything that you've said. Adaptability, things like problem solving are so important to our clients, but also something that really reflected. We did a survey in 2019 called the Transformation of the Digital Workforce, which essentially we collected data across 2,500 employees within the space. So that's marketing, creative, development space. And what we saw across all of those sectors was that the top five soft skills that people expect or they think they're going to be so important in, over the next 5 years, are problem solving and adaptability. Now, I think they can be quite general, you know, for a candidate, you know, what does being adaptable look like? Is it just putting up your hand or, you know, for a client, how do you test adaptability? How do you see in an interview what, you know, if someone's adaptable? And I think the way to do it is to look at the experience and if you're a candidate, if you're a talent in the market, make sure you're putting your hands up. Any opportunities you get, if you're a UI designer, any opportunities you get to work in the research side, great. Any opportunities you get to work with the development team, perfect, put your hand up. And then from there, you can demonstrate the pattern of showing how you're adaptable, how you're flexible within the business. And a great way to do that is to make sure you're upskilling, like you said. And yeah, how what would be the best way for them to upskill, Rosie?
Yeah, so we've got, as you know, Gymnasium, which is really great. It's a free online platform that we have where you can do heaps of different training courses. So we've got like 5 minute ones, and then there's like really full on ones, but all of it's free, and you do come out with a badge once you pass the test at the end. And then the other thing is like go to meetups, go to webinars now, but go to lots of webinars, get a mentor, and then I love people that really put themselves out there to feedback as well. So show your resume around to a couple of people that you know are in the industry. Come and speak to a recruiter about your resume, your portfolio, and really test if it's up to what people are looking for. And I love what you said about putting your hand up to do different jobs and different little things. I think that's really unique and makes people, you know, it shows their willingness to learn and be adaptable in the business. So yeah, really good. Good advice.
Yeah, I totally agree. Not to pat ourselves on the back, Rosie, but good advice. And everyone who's listening, if you need any job advice or you want to have a look at some open roles that we're working on, myself and Rosie will put our links in the top. We'll also put a link to Gymnasium so you can go have a look through there as well. But if there's nothing else, I will leave you to your lockdown weekend, Rosie. Have a fantastic time over in Melbourne.
Cool. All right. Look after yourself and we'll talk soon.
Bye.
Bye.